The next item that we'll be dealing with will be our 550 item, Judy Roundtree, Russell Morgan.
That's me.
Russell is on his way. I don't know where he is at the temperate time I talked to him. He's coming from work. Ladies and gentlemen, what I need to tell you is to refresh your memory. I'm a 100% disabled veteran. I was in air traffic combat operations in the Vietnam War, and I'm 100% disabled right now. And I've born in North Carolina and grew up at Corps Point. I came here to retire. And I wanted to refresh your information. November 14, 2011, we met here, me and my wife, and we wanted a noise ordinance. The lady next door has, at that time, the last report we had was 35 dogs and 3 cats. They're basically in the front yard, in the garage, in the kennels, and they bark all night, all day. When she's gone, they bark. And we've got to the point that we've had to, one of our dogs, when we first got her, I have 5 dogs myself, border collies, one of our dogs got attacked by her. We had to spend $400 of our own money. We've had to barricade our whole entire house, our whole yard with the chain link fence, wooden fence. We become prisoners in our own house. And with the constant of barking, and the state came down and she applied for a license at the state. The state told her, you can't qualify with this. And she's operating a rescue business next door. And if I say something, I said something to her last meeting we had here, and she said, if I don't like it, move out. So, and I would like very much that all the commissioners come out and see what I'm at here. I've got 3 pictures here. These are what's in the front yard. They have 11 dogs in the front yard. The last report was, let's see here, the report, they had 32 dogs and 3 cats. Now they have, they've dropped it down something. They have 22 personal dogs, 3 rescue dogs, and 3 cats. And the problem that we have with the dogs out in the front yard, they've got kennels, and the dogs are in the kennels. Well, they take them out of the kennels and go poop on the back deck. And our house is not that far. In the summertime, it's just obnoxious, just atrocious. And we got to have something done. We met here with the commissioners. We talked with Mrs. Willard. We kept in communications every month. You know, we contacted her. I've got paperwork this high. And we need something from you guys. I don't mind her having 35 dogs over there if they're going to be shut down and not. But we had the landscaper comes in, mows the lawn, they bark their heads off. Somebody drives up and down that driveway, they bark their heads off all night, all day. Then my dog's starting to bark. And I'm stressed to the max. My wife is almost ready for a nervous breakdown. And we are just absolutely upset. And we would like something done. What she does with the excrements from the dogs is she puts them on the backyard and poop on the deck, and then she just brooms it off the deck, and it goes down the back of her house there. And Russell Morgan, I don't know if he's here yet, but he was supposed to be here at 5:30. You guys got to me too soon. He'll be here maybe a little later, but he can't stand it. And we really don't know what to do. I mean, we're living a prisoner in our own house. And everything I've done over there is, according to her, is wrong. I try to be a good neighbor. I'll be a good neighbor with anybody. And I grew up here, and this is my home. I came back after 33 years with Northwest Airlines, and I came back here to retire, and I really don't know what to do. And my next step is to go out to you people here and tell us what we can do. We need some sort of ordinance. The barking noise or whatever Sandy Willard told us and Mr. Taylor told us, what you need to do is go out and call the police. Well, if I call the police every time those dogs will bark, we're going to have a full-time shuttle going back and forth between the police and our house. And we think it's just an absolutely horrendous problem here with this. And I really don't know what to do. It just hurts my feeling that I brought my wife back here from Oregon, and I married her, and she's been a good trooper about this. But at night, she just cries, just almost cries herself to death because of the barking noise. The plumber came the other day, and he said, how in the world do you live with that racket? The 11 dogs in the front yard, and these pictures were taken last Sunday. My wife went around and took the pictures. Those are the ones out front, and there's about 25 more. And then my wife said, my wife's got great hearing, which I don't. I'm deaf in one ear. And she said, I hear puppies over there. So then we saw her ads advertising dogs for rescue in the paper or whatever, you know, on the internet. Out of the woods, the rescue, 11/28/11, the inspector from the state came out, from the animal welfare, came out and says to them that they're disapproved to have a kennel license of any kind, and we were facing that situation. And what I want to know is, if she can't get approval from the state, how can she possibly get an improvement from the county for this? And we are, Russell Morgan's right here, and he'll talk after me, but we are desperate. My wife is just don't know what to do. I mean, if the dogs weren't in the front yard, if they're all in our house, fine. But the stench in the summertime, just putting the stuff out the back deck, it goes down there and it just sits there. And we don't know what to do, you know. And I've had her water tested. I had the water people out there. If I had a house, I certainly couldn't take a house and let the raw sewage run out the backyard, you know. I'd have to have a septic tank, you know. And we're sort of, we want something done, and that's just about all I have to say. And Russell Morgan here, he's our neighbor, and he's also the chairman of our homeowners association. Right here is Russell Morgan.
See, my name is Russell Morgan. Most of you know me. We've been trying to get y'all to, you know, some help for this, and I know y'all put together a subcommittee. Hood, you've actually been out there and seen the problem. She keeps getting more dogs in. But, you know, this is a personal problem with us, but what I had addressed before, to try to get the county to pass an ordinance, not just for us, but for the whole county, to make sure that, you know, if someone comes in here and buys a piece of property and wants to build a nice house, that next week somebody's not going to put a hog pen right next to their house or put 40 deer hounds, you know, up next to their bedroom window. You know, it's not just our neighborhood, but it started there. And what I would like to know, and Al, you and I have sent some emails back and forth, you know, we've had a few glitches in your committee, you know, trying to get this subcommittee and things done. Well, what I'd like to know is, I mean, where are we at this point in getting an ordinance put together?
Well, That Animal Control Committee was disrupted when we changed animal control officers.
Yeah.
And also, we had the election.
Yeah.
And we met recently, and we're still working on the ordinance.
Well, I know at one time you thought that you had talked to you know, what other counties had done, and I don't think there'd been a whole lot accomplished on that so far. I've done a little research, and, you know, someone has to set a precedence. Why shouldn't it be Beaufort County? Let's come into the 21st century and let people know, hey, we want people to move here to this county, and we want you to know you're protected, that, you know, that you're not going to have dog kennels and hog pens and, you know, right up next to your property line.
Mm-hmm. Todd Taylor, he's our new animal control officer. He's sitting right there. And he might be better able to reply in relation to the animal control ordinance and in relation to your problems also.
Well, it wouldn't also always be, you know, as we first stated, you know, when we put in a nuisance ordinance.
Mm-hmm.
So nuisance can cover a lot of territory.
Oh, yeah.
So it's not just necessarily animals, but nuisance in general.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is specifically animal control.
Mm-hmm.
That's a subcommittee that we have.
And they have not made a recommendation to this full board, so there's not a whole lot we will accomplish.
Right. We just wanted to follow up on this and plus let our newly elected officials kind of have an idea of what's going on with us and what we're trying to accomplish here for the county, and not just for our neighborhood, but it started in our neighborhood, and I think it's a good thing for the whole county.
Yeah.
You know, we're trying to change. We're trying to grow. We want to be a better county. Let's do this.
Mm-hmm. It
is bad, but you know, talking about the stench, it's very bad.
Well, that committee will be reappointed tonight, so hopefully and prayerfully after sometime tonight you'll hear from them.
Jerry, you think it's down the line, or maybe before we put something in stone in writing to maybe even have a public hearing on this like they do for the roadside hunters?
Mm-hmm.
Let's get an idea, you know, from the whole county, from the public, you know, what does the public want?
Well, I'm going to tell you like this: until I hear back from that committee, I won't make any recommendations.
I understand what you're saying, but it, you know, something to keep and roll around in the back of our mind and
I understand.
See where this is going to go.
We thank you.
Thank you.
Let me say one last word.